Let's shift our attention, though, Liam, to the top line. Again, Quads is going to join us in like 9 minutes here. We'll get into some more like Canuck-sided stuff then. But Warren Foegele gets to go up with Connor McDavid and Zach Hyman. And that is, how do I word this? It's not last chance for Warren Foegele, but by any stretch. Oh, Quads is ready to go. So we'll get to Quads in like 30 seconds here. But just quickly on Foegele, let's go. Where's contract year Foegele? Like, same thing. Like, again, I haven't had like massive problems with any one of Warren Foegele's games, but I can't think of big moments he's had. And it's the same thing with Nugent-Hopkins and a couple of guys like that, Corey Perry, where it's like, yeah, like they're fine, but can we be a little more than fine? Can we get going? Can we push the pace? Can we do things that you look at the end of the game and go, whoa, Perry did this, helped the Oilers win. Whoa, Foegele scored this goal, had this shift, had this hit, made this play, helped the Oilers win. Nugent-Hopkins finished off a chance, drove offense at 5-on-5. Like, can we get some legit, tangible positives from these guys? Not just, eh, they did okay.
I think we've seen a bit more from Nugent-Hopkins than you're giving credit for to limp him in with Foegele and Perry. I mean, he did have a three-point game against the LA Kings when we were down there as well. And I think overall, he's just been a little bit better. But I agree, he does need to get going. But for Foegele, like, tonight, I just want to see that physicality from him, too. Like, use that speed, bury somebody into the boards. The blue line is big in Vancouver, so, like, make him feel like you're a little bit big, too, right? Like, show that physicality. And he's got some scoring touch, and I think that extra speed next to McDavid is going to be useful tonight.
Yeah. I think for Foegele, like, his time is now, right? If the lineup holds the way that it was during practice yesterday, he's going to be on the top line with Connor McDavid and Zach Hyman. Foegele needs to step up and have himself a game. I think there's no other way to cut it. I don't think he's been like terrible per se, but in the same breath, he got bumped down from the top six to the fourth line against LA. So this is a great opportunity for him. And I like that swap because I didn't think Janmark played good on that top line at all. He did not look like he was able to keep up with McDavid and Hyman. They need somebody on their other wing that can think offense too, right? I think McDavid has shown his ability to be a two-way player. And when you got Matthias Ekholm and Evan Bouchard on the defense there, you know, guy like McDavid doesn't have to be as concerned about super strong defensive hockey because of how good Ekholm and Bouchard are at clearing pucks out from the defensive zone. So Foegele, I'm looking for him to step up. Nugent-Hopkins, I actually think he's been playing fine in these playoffs. Everybody's been really hard on Nugent-Hopkins, but you know, he's got a goal and 8 points in 6 games in the playoffs here. Like, he is producing, he's providing offense for the Oilers, which is exactly what they want from him. You know, can his 5-on-5 play be a little bit better? Could he get some points at 5-on-5? Yeah, sure, that would be great. But I think everybody's looking for that as well. And the last name that I'll throw out there, just in addition to those two, Corey Perry. Let's have a game, Corey. Yeah. Waiting for him to kind of show up in these playoffs so far. Again, don't think that he's been bad per se, but we haven't really seen a Corey Perry playoff performance the way that we were kind of hoping we were going to from him. Now, granted, he's playing on the third line. They're asking, you know, that third line to kind of be a matchup line and a really solid defensive line, which I thought that they have. But at the end of the day, the Oilers need depth scoring. So if that line can chip in a goal or two tonight, that would be a huge help for this Oilers club.
There's been a lot of points where I look at Corey Perry and it's like, go. Like, what do you like? Either move faster or like there's a scrum. He doesn't add it. It's been a weird playoffs from Corey Perry.
What's up, Nation citizens? If you like that video, then you need to be subscribed to the Oilers Nation YouTube. Podcasts, live shows, exclusive interviews and analysis, everything you need from your favorite voices at Oilers Nation. And you don't want to miss any of it, so hammer that subscribe button.